Welcome to Unit 11, Lesson 3, where we'll be learning how to graph a quadratic in factored form. Something I want to talk about right away is this idea about roots, zeros, x-intercepts, and solutions. When looking at the graph of a quadratic, the x-intercepts, where the graph intercepts with the x-axis, are also known as the roots or zeros of the equation. And what that means is that there's solutions to the equation 0 equals ax squared plus bx plus c. So by knowing the graph of a quadratic, you can actually use that to figure out the solutions to a related equation. That actually makes graphing yet another option for solving a quadratic. What we're going to be doing in this lesson is actually going backwards. If we can easily find the solutions to an equation, we can use that to construct a graph. This is easiest when you're in what's called factored form. If your quadratic is written in the form of y equals x minus a number, or plus, times x plus or minus another number, you can easily solve the equation 0 equals that factored form, and those solutions can be used as the x-intercepts of your graph. As you'll see when we start doing one of these, there's going to be an easy trick to determine the x-coordinate of your vertex once you have some x-intercepts. And from there, we can start applying some of the things we learned in the first lesson of this unit. Let's take a look at an example. To figure out the x-intercepts of this equation, we're going to solve the equation 0 equals that same expression. Well, since this is in factored form, we can use the zero product property, setting each of those factors equal to 0, giving us solutions of x equals 4 and x equals negative 2. Those are going to be the x-intercepts of our graph, so I'm going to put a point at 4 on the x-axis and negative 2 on the x-axis. All x-intercepts have a y value of 0, so my ordered pairs will be negative 2 comma 0 and 4 comma 0. Now the next line says y-intercept, but I always go after the vertex next. As we learned in the first lesson, the graph of a quadratic has symmetry. Since the two x-intercepts are at the same y value, the same height, they should be equal distances away from the vertex. So our vertex is somewhere in the middle of those two points. This can be found using a formula in which we add the two solutions together and divide by 2. So we have 4 plus negative 2 divided by 2, or 2 divided by 2, which gives us an x value of 1. So that's the x-coordinate of our vertex. And remember, the axis of symmetry is always equal to the x value of the vertex, so the axis of symmetry is also x equals 1. I can dot that line on my graph so I see it. And next up, we would find the y-coordinate of that vertex. Just as we did in lesson 1, we're going to take this original equation and plug the x value into it. So I plug that 1 into that equation, and I get 1 minus 4 times 1 plus 2. So this gives us y equals negative 9 and makes our vertex 1 comma negative 9. That point's going to be just a little bit off our graph, and I'm going to plot it. And now we're ready to go after our y-intercept. To find the y-intercept, all you do is plug in x equals 0 into the original equation. So we're going to have y equals 0 minus 4 times 0 plus 2, or negative 4 times 2, which gives us y equals negative 8. And that goes along with this x equal to 0, giving us an ordered pair of 0 comma negative 8. So I'm going to plot that on the graph, and then without having to make a table, I can use symmetry to say, well, this is one unit away from the vertex, so one unit to the right should be another point. And I'll take that symmetric pair to now have 5 points to construct my graph with. And now I'm going to go through these 5 points with a smooth curve, and this problem's done. Here's our graph of this equation. Let's move on to a second example. This one's not written in factored form, so we're going to factor it. So we're looking for what multiplies to this negative 5 and adds to this negative 4. And that's negative 5 and 1, giving us a factored form of x minus 5 times x plus 1. So I'm going to put that on the line. Now remember, the x-intercepts are going to be found by looking at 0 equals x minus 5 times x plus 1, which gives us solutions of x equals 5, giving us the ordered pair 5, 0, and x equals negative 1, giving us negative 1, comma 0, which I'll throw those onto the graph. And now we can move on to finding that vertex again. The vertex will be found by taking those two numbers, adding them up, and dividing by 2. And that gives us 4 divided by 2, or an x value of 2. Remember that the x value of the vertex is also going to be your axis of symmetry. So I'm going to roughly plot that on the graph. And next we're going to find the y. The y value of the vertex will be found by taking that x and plugging it back into the original equation. And doing some quick simplifying, that gives us negative 9. Once again, that's just a little bit off the graph, so I'm going to plot it. And now it's time to find the y-intercept. Remember, this y-intercept is just found by plugging in x equals 0. So we get y equals 0 squared minus 4 times 0 minus 5, which just gives us y equals negative 5, making our y-intercept 0 for this x equals 0, comma negative 5 for this y equals negative 5. And we'll plot that point. And once again, we'll use symmetry to say that was 2 units away, and we'll draw another point at the same height that's also 2 units away. And now we have 5 ordered pairs, which will make for a nice graph. Now, something I haven't talked about yet on these two problems is the idea of whether the graph opens up or down. You can visually see that this first graph and the second graph both open up. Without having to make the graph, though, we can tell that this is a positive equation because there's no sign out in front telling us that it's negative. Same thing with number 2, as it has a positive leading coefficient. So that's why both of these equations ended up opening up. Now we move on to number 3, where we have this negative out front, and that's going to lead to the graph opening down. And let's take a look at this one. Remember, to find the x-intercepts, we're going to solve the equation 0 equals negative x minus 3 times x plus 3. Well, the negative's not going to affect the solutions. We're still going to take this x minus 3 and set that equal to 0, which is going to give us x equals 3. And we're going to set this x plus 3 equal to 0, which is going to give us x equals negative 3, giving us x-intercepts of 3 comma 0 and negative 3 comma 0, which I'll throw on the graph. As we've done on the other problems, we're next going to go after the vertex using this new formula of adding the two numbers together and dividing by 2. And that's going to end up giving us 0 divided by 2, or x equals 0, which is the x-coordinate of the vertex and our axis of symmetry. So the y-axis is going to serve as the axis of symmetry for this problem. Next, we're going to find the y-coordinate of that vertex by plugging 0 in for x. We get y equals negative 3 times 3, or y equals negative 9, so y equals positive 9. Keeping in tradition with the other problems we did in this lesson, this point is just a little bit off the graph again. Now, because that point is on the y-axis, that's already going to count as our y-intercept, so we're just going to rewrite it. Now, some teachers in this situation would ask you to go find a couple more points so that we can have the most accurate graph possible, but I'm okay leaving this with 3 points here and just drawing our curve through those 3 points, and that would mean this problem's over. Let's do one more problem quickly here. You may not think to be able to factor this one, but this is a GCF factoring that can quickly turn into 2x times x minus 4. And now I can solve each of these factors to get my zeros of 0, 0 and 4, 0, which I'll throw on my graph. Now this point 0, 0 that's already on the y-axis, that can also count as our y-intercept again. The positive leading coefficient tells me that this graph's going to open up, and now we're ready to go after the vertex. So I'm going to take those two numbers, 0 and 4, add them together and divide by 2. That gives me 4 divided by 2, or x equals 2, as the x-coordinate of my vertex and my axis of symmetry. Now we go after the y-coordinate by plugging that x in. And now let's simplify that. We end up getting 8 minus 16, or y equals negative 8, as our vertex. And this one's actually going to fit on the graph right there. And again, we've got 3 points. We can't find the y-intercept here because we already found it. So I think that's enough to be able to draw our graph. So we're going to connect the dots with a smooth curve, and this problem is finished. In this lesson, we learned that if a quadratic's in factored form, we can find the x-intercepts easily, and then find the vertex using a new formula. From there, we follow almost the same process as we did for standard form. If you came away with anything else, write that down now, otherwise we'll see you in the next lesson.